that we will measure in the milligram. But if we want to measure the weight of tea packet, we will measure in the gram. Tea packet's weight will measure in the gram. But suppose I want to measure the weight of rice, we will measure in the kilogram. Yes, means if it is more, quantity is more, then we have to measure the kilogram. Yes, the same. Now, suppose measurement of length. In measurement of length, suppose I want to measure the length of this chalk, we will measure in centimeter. Yes, suppose I want to measure the length of pole, we will measure in the meter. We will measure in the meter. But if we want to measure the distance between two places, we will measure in the kilometer. We will measure in the kilometer. Okay, now this is about the weight. Yes, now suppose we want to measure liquid things. We are using the capacities for liquid things. Doctors allowing us to take the medicine, that is 5 ml, 10 ml. So that will be measured in the milliliter. Yes. Let's see some examples, conversion of units. Now, 12 kilograms into gram. I want to convert 12 kilograms into grams. Now what we can use? Last year you have learned this triangle. Milli, centi, deci, gram, deca, hecto, kilogram. Milli, centi, deci, gram, deca, hecto, kilogram. Now see, 12 kilograms. So kilogram is down. Now kilogram in which we have to convert in the gram. So while going up, how many steps we are going up? See here. Kilogram. 12 kilogram. Kilogram is here. 1, 2, 3. How many steps we are going up? 3 steps. See here. Gram is here. 12 kilogram into grams. Kilogram into gram. So going up, what we have to do? Multiply. See, each place multiply by 10. See, each step. Multiply by 10, multiply by 10. So 10 into 10, 100, 100 into 10, 1000. So, with which number we will multiply? 12 into 1000. So 12 kilogram we have to convert into gram. So how much gram it will get? 12,000 grams. 12,000 grams. Then next example. Now what it is given? 2 lakh gram. What it is given? 2 lakh gram. We are going to convert in the kilogram. Now gram. See, gram is here. Yes. And we are going to convert in the kilogram. See, means we are going up or coming down. We are coming down. See here, we are going up. Yes, going up, multiply. Coming down, divide. Now gram. From gram, we are going to convert in the kilogram. We are coming down. See, 3 steps down. So 3 steps down means divide by, see, each step divide by 10. So 10, 10, 10. So we are going to divide for this 1000. 3 steps down means 3 zeros are 1. So 2 lakh divided by 1000. 2 lakh divided by 1000. Last zero get cancelled. See, this is upper and upside zero get cancelled. Upper and upside zero get cancelled. So what will be the answer? 200 kilogram. What will be the answer? 200 kilograms. Everyone understood this? One more time I will explain this example. See, first one, 12 kilograms into gram. Kilograms into gram. See, kilogram is down and gram is up. So we are going up. While going up, we have to multiply. 1, 2, 3. 3 steps going up. So multiply by 1000. On 1, 3 zeros will be given. So 12 into 1000, 12,000. Now, if you will see next example, 2 lakh gram into kilogram. 2 lakh grams into kilogram. Now, grams. First, what it is given? 2 lakh grams. So my hand is on gram. And I want to convert into kilograms. So kilogram where it is down. So coming down, divide. Always remember. Moving up, multiply. And coming down, divide. See. 1, 2, 3. How many steps we came down? 3 steps. So divide by 1000. So what will be the answer? 200 kilograms. Everyone understood this? Let's move towards new concept, use of brackets. Write the expression for each of the following using brackets. With these examples, we are going to learn how to use the bracket. Now see, 6 multiplied by the sum of 10 and 16. See, you know? 6 multiplied by the sum of 10 and 16. 6 multiplied by the sum of 12 and 16. We need to write these in the bracket. Why? Because 6 is multiplied forward by the sum of 12 and 16. Here we need to write the bracket. If we will not put the bracket, what you will write here? 6 into 12 plus 16. So it will be the wrong. Here it is necessary to put the bracket. Why? See, 6 first we are going to open the bracket. We are going to solve first bracket. 6 plus 2, 8. 1 plus 1, 2. Yes? So this will come. But if you, and you will multiply, you will get the different answer. Okay? But if you will multiply, see, if you will see this sum, what will be the answer? What you will do? You will look first to this addition. If you will not put the bracket, what you will do? 6 into 12 you will put first. 12, 6 are 72 plus 16. So what will be the answer? 18. Your answer here will be the 18. And 28, 6 are out. 28 6 are 168. See here, 28 6 are 168. So answers are same? No. Answers are different. So here it is required to put the bracket. So here it is required to put the bracket. Now see here, divide the difference. 16 and 14 by 2. Divide the difference of 16 and 14. Difference of 16 and 14. See what it is given. Difference of 16 and 14. Difference is subtraction. 16 and 14. In that whatever answer we are going to get, for that difference we are going to divide by 2. So divide the difference of 16 and 14 by 2. Understood? Divide the difference of 16 and 14. Difference of 16 and 14 means first we are going to find the difference. Yes. Means you are going to find the answer of this. Okay, and that answer you are going to divide by 2. Everyone understood this? Why it is necessary to insert the brackets for the given example? Hello students, let's move towards practice 1.3. Question number 1. kilograms that we are going to add. Okay, so which number we are going to convert? 11 kg. 11 kg in which we are going to convert? Gram means how much grams. Okay, 11 kg means how much grams. Now you have learned this triangle also. Milli, centi, decigram, deca, hecto, kilogram. If we are going up, we are multiplying. And if we are coming down, we are dividing. Yes. Now kg. Where it is kg? Kg means kilogram. Kilogram is here. And in which we have to convert? We have to convert in the gram. Now gram is up. So we are going up. We are going up. Going up means multiplying. So how many? 1, 2, 3. 3 steps we are going up. So multiply by 10 into 10 into 10. So multiply by 1000. So we are multiplying by 1000. So 11 into 1000 is equal to 11,000 grams. What we got? 11,000 grams. Now we got 11,000 grams. Now in that, what we are going to add? Plus 250 gram. Yes, 250 gram. So what will be the answer? 11,250 gram. So do you understand this conversion? 11 kg to 50 gram we need to convert in the grams. So these are the steps. See, first what I did? 11 kg I took. Yes, 250 gram no need to convert because it is gram only. So no need to convert. So 11 kg we are going to convert in the gram. So for conversion of kilogram into gram, see, 1, 2, 3 steps we are going up. So going up, what I have told you? Multiply. Yes, multiply. So multiply by how many steps? 3 steps. So 3 zeros you have to give on 1. So 11,000 grams. So 11,000 grams you got the conversion for 11 kg. 11,000 grams. So 11,000 grams plus 250 grams. So 11,250 grams is the answer. Okay. Now let's move towards next. 56,000 centigrams to gram. Now what it is given? 56,000. These are the centigrams. We need to convert in the gram. Means how much gram? Yes, 56,000 centigrams are given and we need to convert in the gram. Now where is centi? See here. Milligram, centigram, decigram, gram, decagram, hectogram, kilogram. So centigram here. See, where is my hand? Up. And gram is down. See, first what is given? Centigram. Centigram is here and gram is down. So from centigram we are coming down. Coming down. See, I have shown here arrows. Coming down. How many steps we came down? 2 steps. So while coming down we are dividing. Yes? So 10 is 100. So we are going to divide by 100. So 56,000 divided by 100. What will be the answer? Last thing is get cancelled. 560 gram. Means 56,000 centigram is equal to 560 grams. See, 56,000 centigrams is equal to 560 grams. Yes, means 56,000 centigram is what it is? 560 grams. Understood everyone? 56,000 centigram is 560 grams. Once more I will explain this. 56,000 centigrams we need to convert in the gram. Means 56,000 centigram means how much grams? See, 56,000 centigram is how much grams? So what I did? Where? Now centigram. Centigram is here. and gram is down. So two steps we came down, 1, 2. Two steps down. So divide by 100. Going up, multiply, and coming down, divide. So divide by 100 and we did the division. So what answer we got? 560 gram. What answer we got? 560 gram means 56,000 centigram is equal to 560 gram. Understood everyone? Let's move towards next question. Question number 2. To stitch a shirt, 2 meter 15 centimeter cloth is needed. Out of 38 meter 70 centimeter cloth, how many shirts can be stitched? Will there be any cloth left? Now we'll see. Total cloth, how much it was? 38 meter 70 centimeter. Okay. 38 meter, suppose this is the length of cloth. Okay. 38 meter 70 centimeter. This is the length of a cloth. Okay. Out of that, now 2 meter 15 centimeter cloth is needed. Suppose this much part is 2 meter. It is just considered. 2 meter 15 centimeter is this much cloth. For to stitch one shirt, this cloth is needed. 2 meter 15 centimeter. Okay. So how many shirts can be stitched in this cloth? So this suppose we consider for one shirt. Then second, third, fourth, fifth. Means this way we can make the shirts. So what I am doing here? I am dividing the cloth. Now, so in this we have to divide. Okay. Now for division. Now before doing division, what we will do? Cloth is given 2 meter 50 centimeter. Cloth is given 2 meter 50 centimeter. So what we will do in this? We are going to convert meter in the centimeter. Meter in the centimeter. So 1 meter is 100 centimeter. Then 2 meter is 200 centimeter. So 200 centimeter plus 15 centimeter. So for one shirt, how much cloth is needed? 215 centimeter. Okay. Now total cloth, how much it was? 38 meter 70 centimeter. Again, we will convert this in centimeter. 1 meter is equal to 100 centimeter. So 38 meter is equal to how much? 38 into 100, 3800 centimeter. Yes. So 3800 centimeter plus is 70 centimeter. See, we have added because it was the centimeter. So 3870 centimeter is total cloth, and from that for one shirt 215 centimeter is needed. So we have to divide this. 3870 centimeter divided by 215 centimeter. Now what we will do? We are going to prepare the table. 215. Table we are going to prepare, yes. So this is 1s, 2s, 3s, 4s, 5s, 6s, 7s, 8s, 9s, 10s. Yes. And here we will write the carry for this number. Okay. 5 1s, 5. 5 2s, 10. So for this we will write 10 here. 50, carry 1, 5 4s are 20, carry 2, 5 5s are 25, 5 6s are 30, 5 7s are 35, 5 8s are 40, 5 9s are 45. So 4 is carry, 5 10s are 50. Yes, so 5 is carry. Okay, so this over, now this carries we have written here. Now, while writing the table of 1, we are are going to add is carry. 1 1 is 1. Here 2 carry. 1 2 is 2. 2 plus 1 3. 1 3 is 3. 3 plus 1 4. 1 4 is 4. 4 plus 2 6. 1 5 is 5. 5 plus 2 7. 1 6 is 6. 6 plus 3 9. 1 7 is 7. 7 plus 3 10. So 10. 10 means again carry will come, so that we are going to write nearness. Okay, same. Then 1 8 is 8. 8 plus 4 12. Okay, then 1 9 is 9. 9 plus 4 13. 1 10 is 10. 10 plus 5 15. So again carry. Okay, now next we are going to solve next. First now we will cancel this carry, because now which carries we are going to add? These carries. Now 2 1s are 2, as it is. 2 2s are 4. Here there is no carry, so 4. 2 3s are 6, no carry, so that will be 6. 2 4s are 8, here also no carry. 2 5s are 10, no carry. 2 6s are 12, no carry. 2 7s are 14, 14 and 1 15. Yes. Then 2 8s are 16, 16 and 1 17. 2 9s are 18, 18 and 1 19. 2 10s are 20, 20 and 1 21. So this is our table. Everyone understood how to prepare this table? After that you can cancel this carry. So this is only the table to solve it. So now 250. What will come now? First consider this 3 digit. So 215 ones are 215. 7 minus 5 2. 8 minus 1 7. 3 minus 2 1. Now what will come down? 0. Down. Now just see, check in this, which number will come? 8s are 1720. So 215 8s are 1720. So 80 shirts. Is there anything left? No. So how many shirts can be stitched? 18 shirts. How many shirts can be stitched? 18 shirts can be stitched. And will there be any cloth left? Cloth is not left. See, remainder is 0. So the cloth is not left. So 18 shirts we can stitch in this cloth. Everyone understood this? Let's move towards next sum. Question number 3. Rudraksh weighs about 40 kg. What will be the weight in grams of a necklace consisting of 108 such Rudraksh? One Rudraksh. You know now what is Rudraksh? That means it is getting 40. And okay, what will be the weights in gram? Now it is given in milligram. In grams of a necklace consisting of 100 such Rudraksh means, one Rudraksh weights is 48. So 108 Rudraksh weights how much? Now see, it is given for one. Given for one and asking for many. So we need to multiply. What we are doing? Multiplication. So 108 into 40. You know this directly also we can multiply. Okay. 0, 0, 0, 0. Okay. Next steps of 04 exam 32. 4 zeros are 0, 0 plus 3, 3, 4 ones are 4. So how much we got? 4,320. Or else we can solve directly. 108 into 40. See, multiplied by 40. So first only give this 0. This is also one more method. So 4 8s are 32. Okay, 4 8s are 32. 4 zeros are 0, 0 plus 3, 3, 4 ones are 4. See, answer remains the same. Both the methods I have shown. Okay, now you are grown up, so you use this method. Okay, but now 4,320 what we got? Milligram. Answer we got in milligram, mg. But now what it is given? What will be the weight in gram? So milligram you need to convert in the gram. See, 4,320 milligram. Understood, everyone?